So we're up here in this attic and we're on a first follow-up for a rodent trapping and exclusion service. What we did for the first time when we were out was we sealed up all the rodent entry points and we set traps in the service areas like here in the attic. So what we're doing today is coming back for the first follow-up. We're checking all of our traps. We're inspecting the areas of exclusion. And we're checking for other signs of more recent evidence. So we're up here, and this is what we're doing while we're up in your attic. We're taking a look at our existing traps, like here. We're looking to make sure that the bait is still in there and intact. That means that no juvenile rats were at the bait, and that means we missed one. So if we're checking the traps and the bait's disturbed or missing, that means we've got juvenile rats or even maybe mice up in this attic not setting off the traps, and we have to make adjustments for that. But then we're also checking our exclusion work on the AC lines, exclusion work down here in the corner. Another example is we have some pipe exclusion down there. We're checking to make sure that that's intact and that no rats have disturbed it and it's still functioning well. Then of course, we're checking for captures like the ones we have here. This adult rat got captured. We'll be going ahead and getting that removed and taken care of. So just a good example of what we're doing here on follow-ups for rodent services. We have your initial, then we're out here doing follow-ups like this for 2 to 3, maybe even 4 times. Depending on what we're finding during these follow-ups will dictate what we do moving forward.